What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I hope that you're having an absolutely beautiful day. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to Squeeze with their song Cool for Cats. This is off of their album of the same name, which was released in 1979. Now, Squeeze are a band that I have never heard of. I have no idea who they are or anything like that. But I was gifted the Essential Squeeze album by one of you lovely people in the community. So thank you for sending this over. And I figured we would take one of the tracks off of this, give it a listen, give it a whirl, see what's going on with Squeeze. Someone is mowing the lawn, like, right outside. Like, can you guys hear it? Can you guys? Hold on. I don't know. They must know what they like. Anyways, you can join me on Twitter in the comments below, as always. And let's do it. This is Squeeze with Cool for Cats.
The Indians send signals from the rocks above the pass. The cowboys take position in the bushes and the grass. The score is with the corporal, she is tied against a tree. She doesn't mind the language, it's the beating she don't need. She lets loose all the horses when the corporal is asleep. And he wakes to find the fire's dead and arrows in his axe. And Davy Crockett rides around and says it's cool for cats, it's cool for cats. The Sweeney's doing 90 cause they've got nowhere to go. They get a gang of villains in a shed up at Heathrow. They're counting out the fivers when the handcuffs lock again. In and out of Wandsworth with the numbers on their names. It's funny how the missus always looks a bleeding sane. And meanwhile at the station there's a couple of likely lads who swear like as your father and they're very cool for cats. They're cool for cats. To change the mood a little I've been posing down the pub. I'm seeing my reflection, I'm looking slightly rough. I fancy this, I fancy that, I wanna be so flash. I'll give a little muscle and I'll spend a little cash. But all I get is bitter and a nasty little rash. And by the time I'm sober, I've forgotten what I've had. And everybody tells me that it's cool to be a cat. Cool for cats. Onto the wall. I kiss her for the first time and then I take her home. I'm invited in for coffee and I give the dog a bone. She likes to go to discos but she's never on her own. I said I'll see you later and I'll give her some old chat. But it's not like they on the TV when it's cool for cats, it's cool for cats.
right. Squeeze was squeezing out some juice on that one. Excuse me, I don't know. It just went to another song. All right. So, did not expect disco from the band. That was definitely unexpected. So, tell me, are Squeeze one of those bands that makes pop, but it's more like art pop, kind of like XTC, right? Because you could hear it, especially in that break of the song, that there may be more to Squeeze than meets the eye. The singing slash speaking fit very well. Just his very monotone English accented pace. His delivery is very dry. Works very well in the mood of the whole thing. I really love in the chorus when it returns to that disco beat. I like really gets into it and it kind of like lifts it up. I think that's really nice as well. The keyboards and the guitar, especially in that break, they have me interested. I feel like there's something more to this band. Right? Like, first of all, this is the last song on the album, and you can tell, like, as soon as you play it, it's coming off of something, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure it's coming off of the last song, which is Goodbye Girl, which probably and may lead into Cool for Cats, but I'm not sure on that. This is cool. That's pure disco. I love that. Yeah, the harmonies rise up on there, the groove lifts up. It's this break here. It's the break that tells me there's probably something more to this band. I love the electronic sounds that weave themselves in and out of the song. The wonky guitar playing there. The very unpolished drumming as well. And then you almost have like a bar blues piano in here too. I don't know. There's something really interesting about that. I think that that's really cool. On the keyboard is Jules Holland. And the drums is Gilson Lavis. I don't know. I really liked the way that the drumming changed in that section and the way the guitar and keyboard kind of latched onto it and changed with it. So this feels like a good single out of the band. This feels like a good closer for the album, I would imagine. You know, kind of ends the party just right. It says on Wikipedia that this song features a rare lead vocal performance from lyricist Chris Difford, one of only three occasions he sang on a Squeeze single. Now, let's get into the lyrics on this one. The Indians sent signals from the rocks above the pass. The cowboys take position in the bushes and the grass. The squaw is with the corporal. She is tied against the tree. She doesn't mind the language. It's the beating she don't need. She lets loose all the horses when the corporal is asleep, and he wakes to find the fires dead and the arrows in his hat. And Davy Crockett rides around and says, "It's cool for cats. It's cool for cats." So throughout all of the verses, he's mentioning different events or different things happening, and it always comes back to it's cool for cats. So the question is, what do all these different things he's talking about in the verse have in common? To change the mood a little bit, I've been posing down the pub. On seeing my reflection, I look slightly rough. I fancy this, I fancy that, I want to be so flash. I give a little muscle and I spend a little cash, but all I get is bitter and a nasty little rash. And by the time I'm sober, I've forgotten what I've had, and everybody tells me that it's cool to be a cat. So, is it everyone's telling him that it's cool to be a cat, in the sense it's cool to be a cool guy, and he's trying to be a cool guy, but every time he tries to be cool, it's somehow, like, there's a negative or a consequence with it, you know? He goes down to the pub, he's trying to do this and trying to do that, and by the time, you know, he's sober, he's forgotten what he's even done. That's at least kind of what I'm getting out of it, lyric-wise. Anyways, I would love to know what you guys thought of it. You can join me on Twitter in the comments down below. I hope that you're having a beautiful, fantastic day. And I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.